The following contest is an Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring from Capitol Hill, Washington, D.C., weighing in at 227 pounds, Velveteen Dream.
What an entrance. Intoxicating, mesmerizing. A megastar destined for the stratosphere in sports entertainment.
Yeah, known for his combination of ruthlessness and unbridled flamboyancy.
Anything you can do, the Velveteen Dream can do better.
Velveteen Dream just soaking in every ounce of the moment.
Everything about this guy is money. What a superstar.
What an entrance. It's mesmerizing.
It's intoxicating.
What is he doing?
Anything he wants. He's the Dream. You just don't appreciate greatness, Byron.
I'm learning.
Listen to this place!
And his opponent, from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 255 pounds,
this is Triple H's world. The spotlight is his home. A Grand Slam champion, one of the all-time greats.
Yeah, former European champion, former Intercontinental champion, Tag Team champion, and WWE champion.
Triple H is right where he belongs, in the spotlight, with the eyes of the WWE Universe fixated squarely on his chiseled physique. Broke into the main event scene with the likes of The Rock, Mick Foley, Big Show, all at WrestleMania 2000. And has never looked back since. We're talking about one of the most effective, methodical.
Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
Ouch. And it looks to me like this entire arena is on its feet, and understandably so.
The Velveteen Dream already has an iconic style, legion of fans, and multiple Match of the Year candidates. And the amazing thing is that the guy's only 23 years old.
Now you can be sure that by the time the Velveteen Dream finishes performance, a heck of a lot of people are gonna know his name. From behind. Neck breaker. Ouch. Nailed it.
Shoulder tackle. They get dangerous out here, especially when there are no countouts.
Oh.
I'll tell you, watching Extreme Rules matches make me happy. My in-ring days are behind me. You talk about a treacherous environment to compete in.
This is a treacherous match indeed, as Corey was saying. I can't even tell you how many times we've seen Extreme Rules matches result in broken bones, stitches, and even trips to a medical facility.
Yeah, but despite all those inherent dangers, these superstars still willingly sign up for Extreme Rules matches. That's what amazes me the most.
He's got him here. He's got him. Oh!
And he's heading back in. He's making a statement here with this attack.
Beautiful technique.
He's on the defensive now. I'd say he's starting to feel the pressure a bit.
Yeah, he's clearly not on the right side of this match right now, which is a little surprising to me.
Oh, nasty impact.
You gotta believe this one's over.
Beautiful technique.
Boom. And you can see the Dream is looking overwhelmed. Tonight may not be his night, guys.
He's hurt.
It's almost bedtime for Velveteen Dream. He's going to need to get back in this.
Yeah, it's all about sustaining that effort. Let's hope he can do it.
As we've seen countless times over the years, superstars oftentimes try to make a statement with their entrance, and I think it's safe to say that Velveteen Dream did just that, Byron, at NXT TakeOver Philadelphia.
Yeah, and leave it to Velveteen Dream to bring out an on...
Like being manhandled by a bear.
But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
I think Triple H just secured this match.
I think you may be right.
Pedigree!
That has got to be it.
He's got it. Let's see it once more.
Yeah, this match is all but over.
You got to believe this one's over. This might be it.
Oh, my.
You never know what you're gonna see in a match like this. And if you need proof of that, just go back to watch Daniel Bryan versus Kane from Extreme Rules 2014.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hint of weakness in the other.
As Corey mentioned, Daniel Bryan versus Kane from 2014 provided scenes we never thought we'd see. Most notably for me was Bryan carrying Kane back to the ring via a forklift.
That's right up there, Michael. But let's not forget, that was also the match where Kane went through a flaming table.
Oh, my God. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
I gotta say, watching this match, I'm definitely seeing similarities to the May 2016 Extreme Rules match, where Roman Reigns defended his WWE World Heavyweight Championship against AJ Styles.
Look at this! Elbow drop, big time!
Oh, he's got him here, he's got him!
Sidewalk slam! When it comes to brutality, I would agree with Michael Cole's assessment that this match shares similarities with the 2016 Reigns-Styles match. Though for me, the biggest story of that night came after the match.
I'd agree with that for sure. Absolutely nobody thought they'd see Seth Rollins on that night, especially Roman Reigns.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
Oh, shows no mercy. And that poor chair. It looks like a twisted heap.
If you ask me, guys, matches like this where there are essentially no rules are one giant free-for-all where absolutely anything can happen.
Incoming.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
I think we know what this is.
Death Valley bomb. What a comeback.
I like the way you described it.
We've got a cover.
One, two, digging deep for a kick out.
He is not going to go down without a fight, Michael.
I think we're about to see a high-risk move from the top rope.
He might have it.
Look out!
Something that Triple H's opponents have shared is that a way to survive is to keep your composure. The King of Kings is a superior strategist and can effortlessly dissect his adversaries. A challenger must be prepared for that.
T.O. plants him.
Nicely done.
When it comes to battling the King of Kings, and Corey, you touched on this earlier, you must remain focused. Triple H has the ability to use a man's intelligence, strength, and skills against them without breaking a sweat.
When a man stands across the ring from...
Oh, caught him!
Uh-oh, wait a minute, wait a minute! Pedigree! This one's over, guys!
Wow, let's see that again.
Man, he is simply a walking highlight reel.
Harsh impact.
Ooh, what impact.
When it comes to matches like this, I'd say the more innovative a superstar is when it comes to offense, the better chance they have of victory. Michael, that gives new meaning to have a seat.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Wow. Michael, that gives new meaning to have a seat.
As Byron mentioned, innovation certainly is a key in a match like this. A competitor can't be adverse to taking action outside the ring. By no means is this your traditional contest.
No, it's not, Cole, but at the same time, you still win this match the old-fashioned way, pinfall or submission.
Coming next.
We're about to see Pedigree! This one is over.
When I was Triple H here, I can't help to think how he's...
Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Pedigree! That's how you put an exclamation.
We got a cover.
One, two, three.
Unbelievable. This singles match is over.
Well, they don't call it Extreme Rules for nothing, guys. Let's take another look.
These superstars gave as good as they got, and these fans got their money's worth from the opening bell. These superstars gave as good as they got, and these fans got their money's worth from the opening bell.
Here is your winner, the game, Triple H!
And that's a win for Triple H.
Hey, they both gave it their all, but in the end, we were left with the best man standing.